Glory to Jesus. 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 The line, I'm sorry, the line went off because the internet, I think the devil is angry because we are praying and breaking his plans over our life. So the line went off, so I had to reconnect with you on this other second video. Amen. But I want to just encourage you to keep on praying, to keep on blessing God. We are not going to stop because greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. I want you to keep praying. The devil came and tried to stop this broadcast, but we rebuke that devil in the name of the Lord Jesus. We rebuke you, Satan. We rebuke jealous spirit. We rebuke demonic imaginations. We rebuke you, and we continue to decree, and we continue to declare that we are victorious. Nothing is going to stop us. We are unstoppable through the blood of Jesus, through the finished work of Christ. We are victorious. We are not victims, but we are victorious, and we come against any power. We come against principalities and powers that want to stop us in the name of Jesus. We bless you, God. We glorify you, God. We magnify you, God. There is no God like Jehovah. There is no God like Jehovah. I want you to continue to pray. We continue to pray because we are not going to stop, because the devil has a problem. We bind witches. We bind them in the name of Jesus. And we take total authority over this broadcast, over the airways, in the name of Jesus. No weapon that is formed against you shall prosper. No weapon that is formed against your children shall prosper. No weapon that is formed against your home shall prosper. I cancel by the blood of Jesus Christ any accident the enemy has released upon the people of God for this season. We use the blood of Jesus to cancel any other blood sacrifice being done to destroy the people that God has called unto himself. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we cancel accidents. We cancel untimely death in the name of Jesus Christ. I decree and declare, you will live and not die, and declare the works of God. I decree and declare over your children. Your children will live and not die, and declare the works of God. We release the covenant blood of Jesus Christ over our homes, over our churches, over our house, our cars, the road we travel on. We release the power of the blood of Jesus as a protective shield over us. Let God himself arise, and his enemies be scattered in the name of Jesus. We bless your name. We bless your name, Jehovah. We give you praise, Jehovah. We thank you, God. We thank you, Holy Spirit. We thank you, Mighty One. We thank you, Ancient of Days. You are wonderful, God. You know, I came online because so many people in this season, they are discouraged. But you cannot be a partaker of those who are discouraged, because you have a word of God. You are victorious. Jesus Christ won the victory for you. And Christ in you is the hope of glory. The God in you is the hope of glory. He is everything that you need. The same power, the same spirit that raised Christ from the dead sits right in you. Hallelujah. I want you to receive the presence now I'm feeling in this place. And I want you to just begin to pray in your house. You know, so many people want to complain, but we are not complainers. We are prayer people. We are people of gratefulness. We are grateful to God because God has been good to us. So many things have happened this year. We've gone through some trials, but how many of you know God has been on our side? God has been with us. That's why we are still here today. That's why we are still breathing today. That's why we can still pray today. That's why we can still come online today, because God, the God of above all gods, he has been good to us. Hallelujah. I just want to pray for you as you sit there, that God will grace you right now. I pray for them, Lord. Oh God, strengthen your people. I pray strength over you. I pray strength over you right now. I pray the peace of God that surpasses all understanding over you right now. May God bless you and keep you. May God protect you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to Jesus. May you receive the presence of God that I feel right now. May you receive it right now. May the presence of God hit you right now where you are, right now, right now. Let the presence of God hit you in that place of pain right now. Let that pain leave you right now. In that place of pain right now, I decree the power of God over that pain right now. And I command the pain to leave your body right now. Let the peace of God come upon you right now. Whoever is watching me right now. Whoever right now is watching me. Let the peace of God come over you. Let the peace of God that surpasses all understanding. Let it come upon the people of God right now. I pray the shalom of God over you. Receive it right now. Right where you are, by faith, receive it. The presence of God is so heavy in this place. And God wants to touch you. That place where you feel pain right now. Right now, that place of pain. Can you lift it up to God? That place of discouragement. Can you lift it up to God right now? Just invite God in that place of pain, in that place of sorrow. Click on the share button. Invite somebody right now. Share this broadcast on your timeline to bless somebody else. There is a song going on right now, and it's the song that says, "This too shall pass." I may not know what you are going through, but God knows what you are going through. God knows it all. God knows it all, my sister. God knows it all, my brother. Whatever you are going through right now, I want you, wherever you are. Wherever you are right now, give it to God. Right now, wherever you are, just surrender to God and say, "God, here I am." Say, "God, here I am." And give that pain to God. Give that sorrow to God. Give that bitterness to God. Give that disappointment to God. Give that anger to God. Give it to God. Right now, give it to God. Pour it out to God. Pour it out to God right now. This too shall pass. The song says, "This too shall pass." Just give it time. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you, Lord. Almighty God, we thank you, Lord. We bless you, God. This too shall pass. Whatever you are going through, my sister, my brother, this too shall pass. Just tap into this song and worship along and pray along and thank God. Begin to thank God. Hallelujah. This too shall pass. Hallelujah. Whatever you're going through is going to pass. Just give it time and give it to God right now. Give it time and give it to God right now. Oh, Loloba Shantara Baba Baba. This too shall pass. This too shall pass. Whatever you are facing right now, my sister, it will pass. It will pass. It will not stay the same. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Jesus. Oh, Rababa. Oh, Rebebe. Ratobo Karia Baba. This too shall pass. Glory to Jesus. Oh, Rababa. Sukara Baba Yendorobo Sataya. Rikatandi rikabahandelebe. Rasuka rababa. Ore kabandeli kalalobo santalabakaya. Likelebe santorobobo. Ora bakusikiri bikaya kanturiya kapaya. This too shall pass. This too shall pass, whatever you are going through. Hallelujah. This too will pass, my sister. Right now, as you hear this song, begin to pray and give that pain to God. Give that sorrow to God. Oh, Rababa, Surababa, Rekebe, Father, bring out your people. Bring out those in distress right now. I release the garment of praise over the garment of heaviness right now. I decree divine healing by the stripes of Jesus. This too shall pass. Glory. This too shall pass. This too shall pass. Whatever you are going through right now, whatever you are going through, if you know anyone going through, tell them this too shall pass. This too shall pass. You will not stay with it over. Weeping shall endure for the night, but joy comes in the morning. Weeping may endure for the night, but joy comes in the morning. I pray that the mercies of God will find you fresh in the morning. The mercies of God will find you fresh in the morning. This too will pass. Whatever you are going through, whatever the stress might be, whatever the battle might be, whatever it might be, the challenges, you have to know that after the night, the morning also comes. After each night, the morning time also comes. And I just want to encourage you, we have few days to get into the new year. We must not go into the new year defeated. We must not go into the new year discouraged. We must lift up our spirit. We must lift up our eyes onto that hill from whence cometh our help. Our help comes from the Lord. Your help comes from the Lord. I'm going to read a scripture for you. Hallelujah. We are going to read Psalms 100. Amen. Let's read it together. If you have your Bible, let's read Psalms 100 together. And continue to help me to comment, share, like, send some love to Signal people and let them know that we are online sharing out encouragement and praying together. Invite somebody right now if possible and let them know that we are still here praying, we are still here decreeing, we are still here just sharing the love of God together, sharing the word together. I'm going to read Psalms 100 with you, okay? I love the word of the Lord. If you have your Bible with you, if you have the Bible there, just type Amen so I will know that we are all opening our Bible. If you have the word with you, type Amen. Psalms 100 is what we are going to read now, amen? And then we're just going to pray and close for today. And I hope that this moment, even though it was interrupted by the enemy, has been a blessing to you, and we continue to be a blessing to you, and we continue to be a blessing to many people, amen? You can always go back on my timeline to revisit what we have shared, amen? I share daily words of encouragement and inspiration, the word of the Lord, on my timeline. And I really encourage you to, as much as you can, you know, maybe there are also great people out there, but as much as you can, I always have something to lift up your spirit. Maybe sometimes I just have jokes to just, you know, lighten things up. My thing is I want to encourage you. I want to be an encouragement and a blessing to you. So visit my timeline, read some of the things. I believe you will find something that will lift up your spirit. Amen. And share it with those who need it. There are people who need what we are sharing. So share it with a friend, share it with families. When something blesses you, always try to bless other people with that thing. Amen. So I'm going to read Psalms 100 now, if we are ready. It says, shout with joy. 1 minute, please. Just give me a minute, okay? I'm going to get my I'm doing this from my phone and I see that my battery is low. So I'm going to take my battery. If you give me 2 minutes, 2 seconds, I'm going to be back. Don't move. 2 seconds. Okay. Isn't it wonderful? Okay, here I am. Thanks for waiting. Thanks for your patience. So I'm trying to load my phone. 1 minute. Trying to get my phone charged. Okay, there we go. Back on track. God bless you too, Brother Joseph. God bless you and love all of you. By the way, love all of you. Love all of you much. Amen. Love all of you a lot. And Merry Christmas and a wonderful new year. It's going to be a great year. 2017 is a year of the harvest. Amen. So whatever you do, don't miss the harvest. Love you, Sister Mesa. Love you, Lutz. Okay. We are going back to the word. Thank you. Merry Christmas. Love to your family and all that you do. God bless you. And God causes you to just flourish in every area of your life. Amen. Glad to know you. Glad to know you. Hey, Grace is online. Is that Grace? Is that you, Grace? Because sometimes I get the names mixed up. If that is you, Grace, let me know that you are the one. Amen. Hallelujah. We are reading Psalms 100. I see Grace on the line. Grace, is that you? Oh, glory. Psalms 100, we are going to. Okay, Psalms 100 says, shout with joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him, singing with joy. Acknowledge that the Lord is God. Come singing with joy and acknowledge that the Lord is God. He made us and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Amen. Okay, we are going back to it. Acknowledge that the Lord is God. He made us and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving, go into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good, his unfailing love continues forever, and his faithfulness continues to each generation. Hallelujah. This is a word that I just want to bless you with as we go even away today. That we should make it our mandate to continually just praise the Lord and sing with joy unto the Lord. When we go into the presence of God, we should always come with praise. We should always come with thanksgiving. And while I was meditating on Psalms 100 this week, I got a revelation from it. When you are entering into the presence of God, it's good to check your attitude at the door. You need to check your spirit, check yourself, because we have to acknowledge that the Lord, he is God. Amen. And how do we approach our God? He is King. How do you approach a King? Amen. We have to understand in whom we have believed. We have to know who he is. He is mighty. He is great. He is righteous. He is holy. He is all of that. Amen. And when we come into his presence, there are directions that the Bible has given us on how to come in the presence of God. We cannot come in the presence of God complaining, you know, murmuring and just being down and like God has not been good to us. Because when we look at things from the eyes of God, we can have a change of mindset that we always say our God is good for us, to us, and his faithfulness endureth forever. That should be the word that we keep in our hearts and in our minds, in our mouth. Amen. Our God is good to us and his faithfulness endure forever. Amen. So when I was reading Psalms 100, it says that we should come, let me go back to the piece, in verse 4, Psalms 100 verse 4 says, enter his gates with thanksgiving. Enter his gates with thanksgiving. You know, when we are going into the new year, you have to understand that God is not only in 2016, but God is already in 2017. So when you begin to move now into this new year, you are going into the presence. You are already meeting God. You are entering into his gate because he is already there, and he is there waiting for us to come, for him to receive us. But now the attitude we have to have is that of thanksgiving, of praise, singing with joy. Amen. And not allowing the enemy to give us a reason to enter into his gate with complaining and murmuring and, you know, confusion. Amen. So when you come in the presence of God, according to the prescription, I would say, according to how the Bible asks us to do, God will be delighted to see you. Amen. He will be delighted to see me. He will be delighted to receive us, because nobody wants to receive somebody in their home or in their presence all sad, all down, all complaining, like, you know, because the more you complain, the more people don't want to be around you, the more people don't want to do things with you. But when you are a happy, cheerful person with a great attitude, even when things are down, you know, you have a way of even being grateful and saying thank you and all of that, people want to be around you, because you are now like a beautiful scented perfume. Amen. People want to be around you, and people want to do more for you, and people want to give you more if you have a grateful, thankful attitude. So that's the way to go into 2017. That's why I'm coming online doing these videos these last weeks, because I don't want any of my friends to miss out on the blessings that God has for us in 2017. Because one of the things that will cause a lot of people to miss their blessing is their stinky, down, complaining, murmuring attitude. Amen. God does not like people who are not grateful. Amen. Even you, a mother, a husband, a wife, when people are grateful and thankful for the things you do for them, you have the heart that you want to do more. Amen. That you want to do more for them. It's the same with our God. So he's saying, when you're coming in my presence, don't come complaining, don't come whining, don't act as if I've not been good to you. And the psalm is ended up in Psalms 100 by letting us know that this should be our confession. For the Lord is good. His unfailing love continues forever, and his faithfulness continues each generation. So when you come in the presence of God, no matter what you've gone through, your final declaration should be, our God is good. His faithfulness endure forever. That's something you should keep close in your mouth in this season. Amen. Does that make sense? Did that bless you a bit? If it blesses you, amen. Share it with people. Share the word with people. Share this video. Amen. And keep enjoying the broadcast. And I hope that the prayers that we prayed before have really encourage you. If not, I posted it because Facebook had to cut it off. I don't know why, but the devil was mad. Apparently they cut it off, but I had the opportunity to still post it on my timeline. So to give you that prayer fight and energy, please visit my timeline and get that broadcast and still listen to it, because when you listen to it, what it's going to do is going to activate you. Right, I want you to remain activated whenever you feel like that complaining enemy or discouragement devil is coming back onto you. I encourage you, go on my page. You can click on my videos. You know, when you go, you click photos. From the photos, you will see albums. You will see all my videos for the past year. You can click on one or two of them, and there is always something about prayer, a word of encouragement, you know, just to lift up your spirit. Amen. So I love you. I bless you. I thank you. Thank you for all the good comments, the whatever the comments are. I thank you. Thank you for the likes. Thank you for the love. Thank you for the private messages and encouragement that all of you keep sending to me. I'm telling you, I love them. I love them. They bless me. But because there are so many friends that I have, sometimes I have like mails, like, you know, I have all of that coming. And then I can't really respond to everybody and everything because of my workload. I travel also a lot. I minister a lot, you know, around the nation. So it's not always possible for me to respond to each and every one of you personally. But I do try to read some. The ones that I can see, I read some of you. I see the things that you share on Facebook as well, the ones that speak to me, I like, and you know, nice pictures, you know, but sometimes I don't see anything. So don't be like, oh, she doesn't, you know, interact with me, or she doesn't like my things. It's not like that, please. Okay, it's just that I'm busy with some things of the Lord and family and everything, so I don't see everything. Amen. But I thank you and I love you, and I wish you a blessed festive time with family and friends. And please go to church, stick with God, okay? No matter what is going on, read your Bible daily, pray daily, declare the word of the Lord over your life daily, declare over your children. Parents, be careful what you speak over your children, amen? Because your words, they have power and they will come to pass, positive or negative, amen? So be careful what you speak over your children. Be careful what you speak over your new year. Begin to now. Don't wait until 31st of December to begin to declare what you want to see in 2017. Begin to declare right now, my God has been good to me. Declare, I am victorious. I am unlimited. I am the head and not the tail. Begin to declare the words of the Lord over you. Amen. God bless you. And I am about to leave you for now, but we will speak again and we'll see each other. Who knows? And Sister Mesa, I know you are planning to come to the gathering of the intercessors. Please, if possible, it's going to be fireworks. I'm telling you, it's going to be fireworks. If it's possible, try to make your way down over here. We'll be glad to receive you. Amen. Follow me on Facebook. I don't know if you have sent the email. As soon as we have the email, one of our team people will contact you and give you all the information that you need. Because we also have some really good hotels that we can recommend to you, you know, also for a good price. And we would really like to have you with us. If you can come with some people as well, that will be great. Amen. So I'm going to say yes. Okay, so I'm going to check. Okay, I'm going to check with the team and allow them to check the emails because of the season of now, you know, the festive and season and everything. The mails are a kind of lacking behind, but we are going to check everything and get back to you and all those who are coming. The conference is free. Only one of the days in the morning, there's a special session with Apostle Ryan Lestrange. It's a session of impartation and you know, anointing service and everything. And we have lunch together with the man of God. We can ask questions, you know, it's going to be really personal. And lots of pastors, apostles, prophets, and all of that are going to be around. So that one, you can, when you are here, you have to pay 15 euros for that one, only for that one session. Amen. It's session for leaders, but you can be part of it and everything. Amen. So any other information, just send it to the email, and you will, trust me, before April you will get all the information. Amen. God bless you. And for those of you who are still online, just like 2-3 people online, it doesn't matter for now. People will always watch this broadcast later. I really encourage everybody to be part of the gathering of the intercessors movement. It's something that God is really doing. So we want all of you to be part of it. But check my website also, www.clairereveal.org. www.clairereveal.org. Amen. So you can get more information from that website. But you can also ask me things through Facebook private, you know, messenger, and I will respond as soon as possible. I really need to go now, okay? Hope this has been a blessing to you. I love you, and God bless you. Take care of yourself, take care of your family, and keep it coming, and keep the love. Amen. God bless you. Bye-bye. Thank you, Sister Mesa. Bless you. Bless you. Bye. Bye.